Hello, Eva buddies. How are you all? I hope all are well and all is well. Today's session is on letter writing. Writing letter is very important in our life, right? Today, nowadays, we send letters not only by post but also through emails. So, letter writing is an important part where we have to learn how to write letters to different people. Normally, letters are broadly divided into two types. First one, informal or personal letters. We write informal letters to people in the family, that is blood relatives, friends or others whom we know closely, right? Next is formal or business or official letters. We write formal letters to people we don't know personally for business purposes or formal reasons. For instance, if you want to write to the principal of the school or one you want to order some books from the bookstores, or you may want to lodge complaint about any article. For example, a new TV that has been broken down. And for other business purpose, in for all formal reasons, we go for formal letters. Informal letters also include letters to write to the editor of the newspaper or a magazine. Apart from whom they are addressed to, formal and informal letters vary in different layer, style and their structure. Today, in informal letter, we can see the various features, right? Various features of the informal letter. Sender's address, date, greeting, salutation, first paragraph, body of the letter, complimentary clause, subscription. I have taken an example of Raju writing a letter to his grandfather about his experience on quarantine days due to COVID-19. First part is sender's address. What do you mean by sender's address? The person who is writing the letter, that person's address is called as sender's address. Now Raju is writing a letter to his grandfather, right? Raju is the writer. So, writer's address will be mentioned on the left side of the page. Next comes date. On which date he is writing the letter, that date will be mentioned. After date, we will go for greetings or salutation. Can you see here? Raju has greeted his grandpa, dear grandpa. Suppose if you are writing a letter to your mother, then dear mother. If you are writing a letter to your auntie, my admirable auntie, my lovable auntie, whatever you want, any exaggeration can be written in greetings or salutation in different forms. Next comes paragraph. That is, before writing the body of the letter, you can start with the first paragraph. That is opening of the letter. Opening of the letter deals with wishes or greetings to the person. Can you see here? Raju, he has written, I am so happy. I am coming to stay with you for a month. I love you because I can be with you. So he is wishing, he is greeting to his grandfather. That will be the starting, opening of the letter. Next comes body of the letter. Body of the letter, one can mention the ideas, their views, for what reason they are writing letter. Other details can be mentioned in the body of the letter. It doesn't mean that paragraphs, only two paragraphs, three paragraphs, like that only you have to write. Paragraphs are not restricted. How much of a paragraphs you can utilize in informal letters, but it will be written in informal ways, not informal ways. So, can you see in the body of the letter? Raja has written, I have to tell you about my days during quarantine period. Mom never used to send me out for play. always playing indoor games, reading story books, attending online classes. Mom just told me the next month she will take me to your place so that I can accompany you. That is the body of the letter of what Raja has written. So in the body of the letter, what all you can see? Detail for what reason he is writing the letter. The detail and other things, his views can be mentioned in the body of the letter. Next comes closing the letter, complimentary close. If you want to wish to any others or you want to convey message, that conveying message can be concluded in the last paragraph, that is complimentary close. Here can you see, convey my regards to grandma, see you soon. That is what Raja has written. So complimentary close, that is closing the letter, you will convey the message for others or whatever you have to conclude. So conclusion will be the last part of the letter. Next comes subscription. He has written, your loving grandson. Subscription can be written in different ways. Instead of your loving grandson, you can use yours affectionately, or your loving daughter, or your loving son, or whatever it is. In different ways you can use subscription. Last comes signature. Signature, only the first name will be written in the signature part. And also you have to keep in your mind, while writing informal letter, personal pronouns can be used. I or we can be used, and also contraction. Have you seen? I am. Can you see here? I have. Contractions and abbreviations can be used in informal letters. So it can be written in informal way. Thank you. Morning. Today let us know more about formal letter. As you see in the example given, the format of the formal letter has different features compared to personal letter. Which are the parts of the formal letter? We see sender's address, receiver's address, date, then subject, salutation or greeting, body of the letter, then subscription, signature. These are the parts of the formal letter. They vary slightly with their features compared to personal letter. What are the differences you find from personal letter to formal letter? You can see. I have taken one example for formal letter. That is, write a letter to the principal requesting him or her to issue transfer certificate. This is the example what I am taking. So this is a letter written by a student Gokul to the principal. So from address, we will write Gokul's address. He has written the address. This is called as from address. From address is nothing but sender's or writer's address. The person who is writing a letter, who is writing the letter, his address will be called as from address or sender's or writing the receiver's writer's address. Next come two orders. For whom the person is writing? Here, Gokul is writing to the principal. So, two address will be the receiver's address. So, he has written the address, two address. After writing two address, you can mention the date on which date the sender is writing the letter. That date will be mentioned. In personal letter, you can't see the receiver's address, right? Here, in formal letter, it is necessary to write receiver's address. Then comes date. Afterwards will come subject. Subject or reference. For what purpose you are writing a letter? That one you will write. Here comes a Gokul is writing to the principal requesting him or her to issue transfer certificate. So subject will be application for school transfer certificate regarding. After writing subject, next comes salutation or greeting. In personal letter, subject or reference is not necessary. But in formal letter, it is necessary to write subject or reference. So salutation or greeting
principal, respected sir or madam. So greeting, often greeting, body of the letter stress. For what purpose he is writing this letter, the detail of the letter, and other details will be mentioned in the body of the letter. As mentioned above, I want to state that I was a student of your prestigious school. I have passed 10th class from your school and secured 95%. For further studies, I need transfer certificate to be admitted in your school. I have no pending dues. I clear everything. So please kindly issue my school leaving certificate and do need. This is the body of the letter. After writing body of the letter, you will go with the word thank you. That is the closing of the letter. Next comes subscription, your obedient student, then signature of the sender. That is the end of the letter. So if you come into subscription, he is writing to the principal. So if any person write letter to either principal or the teacher, class teacher or concerned teachers, you will end up with salutation, obedient student. Suppose one writes for business purpose, normally its subscription will end up with yours faithfully or yours sincerely. For school purpose, it is yours obedient student. Then end up with the signature. So normally, what is the difference you find in personal letter and formal letter? Formal letters, the language will be in formal way. You will give detailed description, paragraph wise, but unnecessary details are not necessary. Only required details, whatever you have to mention, will be written in formal language. No contractions or abbreviations are used in formal letters. And also one can see receiver's address, subject, and also end up with the letter